Hello, my name is Scott Fagan. I'm furniture manager here at White Plains Crate & Barrel in the Westchester Mall.
And I'm Carol Ann Maughan, the gift registry manager at the Crate & Barrel White Plains Mall.
What you're about to see today is a glimpse into our gift registry program. And what you're going to learn today is Carol Ann will talk to us a little bit about working with young couples setting up their gift registries. And we're also going to talk about a little bit about thinking about the future beyond the registry experience.
So yesterday we had our first fall event, which was a collaboration with Simon Mall and other vendors who have bridal wares. And today was our first of the fall registry events. And what we have done in the past year is we have created a community of interested people who are here to help us create these events and do it in a very sophisticated, welcoming way. So we had the participation of Whole Foods, we had Heidi and Arthur Chocolatier, artisanal chocolates, we had our wonderful florist, Annette from Perennial Gardens.
Hi, I'm Annette with Perennial Gardens. We're a full-service flower shop in Bedford, New York. And we're here today at Crate & Barrel participating in one of their weekend bridal events. Today we brought with us some fall flowers since we're in the middle of October. And we brought a table runner, a bridal bouquet, and perhaps a place card arrangement. This has been an excellent program for us. We've got to meet so many brides here and do some of their weddings. But we've also gotten great exposure. People just walking through the store and seeing the arrangements have come to Bedford and looked us up. And it really has been an excellent opportunity for us. We appreciate being part of this.
We've come to Crate & Barrel to celebrate their bridal party event and registry sign up. We work with the Crate & Barrel on a regular basis and promoting Whole Foods and also promoting Crate & Barrel products. Today we're making omelets and treating our brides and grooms to some omelet breakfasts as they're shopping this morning.
Well, our registrants have been welcomed. They're being wined and dined upstairs. And while they're doing that and being escorted on to the furniture floor to see our offerings there, I'm going to go through the steps of the registry process. I compiled all the information we had, and I shortened the process in a way to make it easier for everybody to hold on to. And I broke it down into four steps. The first is to engage, and that's the part where we congratulate and welcome and bring people over to the kiosk. The second part is the enrollment process. And then I go in here and I have a log in which I take down the registrant's information and the salesperson who helped them, and whether they're a new registrant or they're editing, and whether the gift has been given, making sure that all that information is intact. And then I give them a scanner, as well as the one and only gift registry list, checklist. And then we take them over to the different parts of the store to explain to them how to go about ordering the objects we have. As I'm going around showing them, that's what we call the enhancement process, where we explain to them the different things we have and how to use them. We give them the information, which enhances their whole registry experience. And then finally, we come over to the kiosk, and then it's time to download the registry and take the scanner, put it in. I guide people into telling them where to do it and get them to go through the process. Have them go through all the steps so that when they come in the second time, they'll be very familiar and comfortable with it. And I not only talk to them about it, but I demonstrate how to go about it and which buttons to press. And I find that they retain that information more easily if they're shown it as well. And I will stand here, except when they're putting in, creating a password. I don't want to interfere with that. And then I wait until the registry prints out, and we make sure that it's as they have wished it. So once we're sure that is correct, I take them through all the steps on the front page, their information, the thank you manager, where the number will appear the next time. And then I go back to the log, give them back their license or any ID that they have, put the scanner back, and then we go over to the counter over here, and then we give them the gift and thank them for choosing Crate & Barrel to register. So basically, we've taken us through the four steps. We start with the engage, and then we enroll, then we enhance, and then we end. And that's basically our registry process in four simple steps.
Think about the future. That's our latest initiative for our gift registry program, educating our registrants on the wonders of the furniture showroom. Currently, almost 95% of our registered SKUs come from the Housewares channel. We're trying to change all that by having our managers and our associates here on Bridal Sundays to educate our young registrants on life after the wedding.
And what we're doing, Scott, is trying to build customers for life. And we see them come in again and again as they, several years into the marriage and after they have children, and then they start adding to what they have and they've already got a background. We've had people come in and say, everything I have is from Crate and Barrel. So with the new registrants, we're really interested in creating that kind of relationship.
Thank you once again for joining us for our Crate Works experiment.
And we look forward to your feedback, all of it.
Toodaloo! Toodaloo.